हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आज टॉपिक जो हम पढ़ने वाले हैं दैट इज़ पीपल एंड एनवायरनमेंट. सो द फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज एनवायरनमेंट, व्हाट डू यू थिंक ऑफ इट?
एनवायरनमेंट इज समथिंग इन व्हिच वी आर लिविंग, लाइक इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ डिफरेंट थिंग्स अराउंड अस, लाइक आवर एनवायरनमेंट, वेदर और लाइक पीपल, कल्चर एंड ऑल दीस थिंग्स कंसिस्ट ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट.
ओके, गुड गुड. Environment, you are right that environment is actually the sum total of physical things happening around us, right? तो आपको क्या लगता है कि environment के क्या types हो सकते हैं? What can be the types of environments? Do you think that all the environments are suitable for living beings?
No, somewhere like land of earth is like earth is very wide, but we cannot live there. We can't live somewhere there. Temperatures
too high. Yes. So basically, if you talk about the earth, there can be many areas which are either too hot or too cold. So the person cannot survive there. Or there can be areas which are very dry, where there can be no vegetation, or there can be very marshy. So yes, there are only certain areas where people can live in. So those areas where people can live in are called acumen areas. And the areas where people cannot live, they cannot inhabit those areas, are called non-acumen areas. So if you talk about the types of environments, there can be divided into three types. Like, any idea which can be the three types of environments?
One category can be where people and living things live.
Okay.
And one category can be like consist of culture and our religious activities.
Okay, so basically we can divide our components, environment in three different types. The one can be your physical environment, one can be your biotic environment, and the third we can call it as a cultural environment. So what are they? First we will talk about physical environment. So physical environment basically talks about the air and the land and everything around. That is our physical environment. Do you want to say something, ask something about it? Physical environment. Can you give me some example?
Physical environment, like as you said, air and your land where you are living, the types of gases are producing there. Like if you live in a society, you cannot have like factories there. They will actually increase the number of the gases, okay, quantity of gases. So that's why we are separating industrial and living areas.
If you talk about the physical environment, it basically includes everything. I mean, here we are only talking about the physical things which are present here. It can be your land, it can be your water, it can be air, anything which is in a non-physical, I mean a physical form, non-living form, we can say. The second is your biotic environment, which includes all the things which are living. It can be human beings, it can be animals, it can be plants, microorganisms, anything which have life comes in the category of biotic environment. And what are cultural environments? Okay. Yeah, culture is a part of your society, your behavior, your religion, anything like that. But if you talk about the cultural environment, we can say that all these cultures, they have an impact on the environment also happening around us. Like we can say, like in Buddhism, killing is prohibited. So the areas or the people which follow Buddhism, they don't kill they don't kill any animals, or basically like silkworms, if you talk about. For making one silk sari, you know that there are around 5,000 silkworms which are killed to make one silk sari. So the areas where Buddhism is followed, they don't, allow killing of silkworms or rearing of silkworms. Similarly, in Hindus, you know, we have different trees which we worship, like banyan tree, peepal tree, or sometimes, you know, we have trees like banana trees in the South India. They are worshipped at the time of marriages and all that. So those trees are also not allowed to cut down in those areas. So this is what we call as a cultural environment.